Hey everybody, welcome back. Let's talk about what makes a great creative director. If you're a company that's looking for the perfect agency, a creative director is a critical piece of that decision. They're going to be the linchpin in the success or the failure of any project that you give. If you're a creative pro who's looking to get promoted or move up in your career, you may have your eyes on management, or you maybe have watched too many Mad Men episodes and want to find out the truth about what a creative director does. Let's talk about what makes a great CD. First of all, just a little bit of context. I've been a creative director for over 20 years working with global retailers, global agencies, and global consumer products companies. I've worked with over 50 of the Fortune 500, and I've led teams as small as 2 and as large as 65. So let's define the role of a creative director. First of all, yes, they direct the creative work, but they do a whole lot more. Many designers want to be creative directors because they think all they do is give creative advice. They tell other people what to design and what to do. They come up with ideas and they have other people do it. Well, yes, the creative director does give creative feedback, but their feedback has got to be well thought out. It's got to be constructive. It's got to be motivating. It's got to be smart. It's got to be strategic and intelligent and clear. After meeting with the creative director and getting briefed, the creative staff should really have a very, very clear idea of where they need to take the work. Great creative directors are well-versed in all the aspects of an agency's business. Great CDs have been copywriters or art directors, designers, illustrators. 99.9% of creative directors have come up through the ranks, through their careers, from junior designer, designer, senior designer, before they've become a CD. You don't just walk in to a CD role. And although they're experts in one discipline, they have to really understand all the creative crafts. They need to know how to guide copywriters, even though they may not be great copywriters themselves, even though almost every single great creative director I've known in my career is also a great copywriter. Great CDs also know every creative brief intimately. They know how to take a bad one and make it better. They're fully understanding of the business problem that needs to be solved, not just the design problem. They understand the client customer, and they also deeply understand the end consumer that's going to be motivated and moved to action by the design work that they're doing. A great CD also has a broad range of experience. They've worked with different clients, different industry categories, different products and services. They've worked with different personalities and different managers and C-suite executives. They also may be very well versed in working with different divisional areas, account management, finance, strategy, media, production, etc. They really have to be really, really well versed in a broad range of disciplines. A great creative director is also a great storyteller. They can make a moving and striking presentation out of just about anything. Creative directors happen to spend a lot of time making keynote presentations and PowerPoint decks. They can lead the client through a mental journey, adding business and design context to whatever it is that they're going to show. They warm up the client to the work before showing it, and they frame it out in the context of the creative brief. They bring the client along with them on a journey of their thinking. They act basically like a shepherd or a guide to the work. A great creative director is also a great salesman. Great creative directors can present anything and sell anything. They can persuade a warm audience. They can persuade a cold audience, a hostile audience, a bored audience. They can skillfully manage any kind of negative feedback that they get. They can steer conversations. They need to be unflappable, essentially. They need to be not easily intimidated, because lots of senior managers, C-suite executives, love to intimidate. Let's face it. A great creative director also has to exude a certain level of authority and confidence. They have to be really comfortable speaking to and presenting to very senior level people and making big decisions that are going to affect the work. They need to be able to operate on vague and sometimes really incomplete information. A creative director is also a messenger and a translator. They may hear vague feedback from the client, like, I'm not feeling it, or it doesn't pop, or there's no wow factor. They have to decide and decipher really what that really means and translate it into actionable feedback that they can then communicate back to the design team, making it clear and actionable and positive and meaningful and motivating. They have to know how to dig into client comments and really pull out the essential information that the team can use to make the work better. I want to take a short break and tell you about a cool group I've started. It's a private Facebook group called Brand Design Masters. It's a community of creative professionals and entrepreneurs who are networking and sharing feedback and news and resources and trends with each other. It's a really great, vibrant group, and I invite you to come over and join. Just go to facebook.com/groups/branddesignmasters and join today. Great creative directors also have to be selfless creatives. Sometimes creative directors get a really bad rap that they're prima donnas or divas, but a great creative director is really, actually, and should be very humble. They don't take all the glory. They pass that glory on to their team. But when things do go wrong, I tell you, the creative director is always the one who takes the blame. They help the creative director do their best work. They clear roadblocks for them. They clear misunderstandings. They protect them from any kind of distractions. They make sure that they understand the creative brief, and then they guide and redirect them if necessary, and they protect them from the inner workings of the in-house company or the agency that they work for, so those designers can do their best work. A great creative director is also a great people motivator. They know what any individual designer or creative needs to perform at their best. Does that person need quiet? Do they need an energetic environment? Do they need ego stroking? Do they need a little bit of pressure applied? But they also know how to give fair and clear feedback. And most importantly, they can hear honest pushback from the designers and really hear it and incorporate it, that they're not totally one-sided about what they think. A great creative director improves the work by getting the best out of their staff. Another important quality of a creative director is that they have to have a real eye for talent. They hire and train the creative staff. So they hire writers and photographers, illustrators, web developers, 3D artists, motion designers, audio and video editors, as well as graphic designers. They really have to know how to recognize creative talent, but also they have to be able to recognize great communicators, great verbal and written communicators. They have to be able to watch out for and find the prima donnas and the divas in the audience, so those problematic personalities that may affect a studio in a negative way. They have to also be able to recognize leadership potential in their staff, people that they can grow and how to grow them and mentor them and challenge people so they can move upward in their careers. When it comes down to it, creative directors are like octopuses with a million arms. They're department managers and agency politicians. They're salesmen and budget planners. They're strategists. They're sometimes even therapists, human resources representatives. They're red tape cutters and trend gatherers and firemen putting out fires everywhere. They have a million arms. And finally, the one thing you got to know about creative directors is that the buck stops with them. So, did the presentation flop? Did the client hate the work? Was the team stuck and had no ideas? Did we run out of a budget? Was the budget too small? Were the deliverables too big? Was the timeline too short? All of those things land on the creative director's table. Creative director is usually the first to arrive and the last to leave. When no one knows how to handle a situation, when the dookie hits the fan in a project, a great creative director will have some idea of how to handle it. And they muster up the team and put it together to tackle it head on. So that's it. Thanks for watching this video on what makes a great creative director. And if you did, please hit subscribe below and hit that notifications bell so you can get alerted when I post something new or when I go live. And if you need help with your brand strategy, brand design, building a creative department, or your professional creative career, trying to get to a CD level, reach out to me at philipvandusen.com and let's see what we can do to get you to the next level. And with that, thanks again for watching, and bye for now.